chat right now with hashtag MB. The gates are now open. Let's see who can take the first game of the day.
This blind pick is interesting from Method Black. I was expecting a Demon Hunter Death Knight, but they obviously are respecting Change My Mind's Wizard Cleave composition. So instead, we're actually getting a Game 1 Wizard War between Change My Mind and Method Black. I'm trying to just take the time to assess who theoretically got the upper hand in terms of these compositions. I would say that Valet's team brings a bit more extra crowd control with that Psychic Horror and Silence combination, but as the Shadow Priest trying to cross midfield against a Frost Mage to secure that crowd control, it is going to be difficult to utilize properly. Deeper into Dampening, I do believe that the Elemental Shaman is going to have the upper hand with this Lightning Lasso currently activated on Valet, dealing devastating damage. Good cross crowd control initiation by Method Black as Chaz continues the chain. Now they just need a tad bit more damage to force cooldowns here onto Fried Kitty as they make a swap. And Foyke denies the remainder of that damage, having activated Iron Bark. Chaz now silenced. Valet looking to start a crowd control chain, but not in range to really threaten anything further.
Yeah, I don't think this is a bad matchup for Change My Mind at all. I think this is probably one of the compositions they'd like to play against as this. But Valet getting low in the Lightning Lasso once again. You said that is going to be a lot of the burst damage that Swapsy has available. Beautiful Cyclone coming in from Chaz. Can they take Valet down right now? Could be an immediate dispersion. Doesn't want to play too greedy. Uses the dispersion, gets topped off from that healing. And Poike going to be playing that balance affinity, the Moonkin form, which makes it much more difficult for Raikou to secure polymorphs. But if they do make a swap on him, and Poike potentially could go down. Nice little attempt on Chaz right now with a bash. And Poike trying to get a little bit aggressive, but they really don't have the damage to force out anything more than just a bark skin.
Yeah, I mean, still just taking opportunities to try and go after the healer. I think deeper into dampening is definitely a win condition for either team's composition. The main goal in this matchup is to just max out your damage as much as possible. Sneak in a couple of crowd controls that are not risky, so you will unlikely see these mages casting polymorphs on the Restoration Druids. It is already difficult to polymorph a druid, but at this level, between the skill that Minpoike and Chaz have, it's almost impossible. So you will often see the mages instead just focus their priority on Frostbolt in this case, as they're both playing the Frost specialization. Frostbolt then lets them accrue icicles, which appear above their character's head. They can count it up to 5, and then choose to release all 5 icicles with a spell called Ice Lance. They will then combo that with some crowd control. So for the case of Method Black, that's going to be Swapsy's Lightning Lasso. In this case, for Change My Mind, it will be a condition there with the Silence and the Psychic Horror. So Valet will be the initiator. Then we will see Fried Kitty back him up with all those icicles he has spent generating throughout the fight. And then the opposite end, Swapsy will initiate with Lightning Lasso, and Raikou will be the follow-up with the damage.
Yeah, and both these mages are opting to use most of the Frostbolt Azerite traits, so they're going to be empowering both of their icicles as well as their consistent Frostbolt damage. So looking for as much casted damage as possible, which will add up. Valet getting low in a Lightning Lasso. Could be dispersion once again. Another beautiful Cyclone from Chaz. Anytime Valet gets low, Chaz is finding these Cyclones that they can burst out of, as long as there's a little bit of crowd control. Ooh. Minpoike, Raikou sneaks in a Sheep. Valet in a lot of trouble, activating that Fade. That will make him safe. A nice Double Fear coming in from Valet. Tremor Totem gets dropped out by Swapsy, and that's one of the utility spells that a Shaman does bring. That Tremor Totem will be able to break himself and his team out of fear if he needs it, and that's basically the counter to what Valet has available. So look for Swapsy to be breaking out Chaz and Raikou from fears if Valet can ever secure them.
The Shadow Priest brings a lot of sustained, consistent damage across multiple members of the team, but it doesn't really bring a huge punch of burst that, with paired up against the Elemental Shaman, that does. Basically the exact opposite in terms of damage output from the Shadow Priest. And in the current meta, sustained damage is just not that great, especially facing Restoration Druids, who have very powerful heal over time effects that they can spread to their members of their team quite easy and quickly. So instead, I would give the advantage here to Swapsy. Just having that heavy hit during burst windows has been what the teams have relied on to win in the current meta. The Shadow Priest is just a bit lackluster in that regard. Every single Lightning Lasso, every 30 seconds, that's always a threat. Valet's crowd control is just a tad bit longer than that, so they get less attempts, they get less burst. You can already see that that's establishing itself in Minpoike's mana pool. Minpoike actually trying to sit down and regenerate some of that to try and edge ahead over Chaz, but overall, there's just been really no pressure for Change My Mind whatsoever compositionally, and Method Black's decision to go into a Wizard War rather than rely on their Demon Hunter Death Knight composition, I think, was a wise move.
Yep, Raikou's blinking behind the pillar, back to Chaz, taking a little bit of burst damage. Swapsy repositioning on top of Valet, looking for a lightning lasso. Immediate interrupt there by Fried Kitty, nicely done. As we move towards dampening, we can look at the healer's mana. Right now, Chaz has a bit of a lead over Minpoike, potentially could go look for a drink at some point, but I think with the way these two teams are positioned, it's gonna be difficult for either one of these druids to sit down and get a drink. They're probably gonna have to cross the map at some point, but if they do cross the map, their team will lose a lot of pressure, so it's a risky situation indeed.
All right, we do see some initiation here by Change My Mind. Finally, some pressure as Fried Kitty has managed to sneak in a polymorph. You don't usually see these druids at this level getting caught in that crowd control, and you can see how much pressure is developed if you can find an opening like that. Unfortunately for Change My Mind, not netting them any cooldowns, so no real significant lead established from that nice play. Now we see Method Black engaging with crowd control. Minpoike caught into a bash polymorph as Method Black push on top of the enemy team. Valet already in a good position to just avoid the attack entirely, and nothing is going to be banked on either side at this point. It's really mana that is the name of the game before we get into deeper stages of dampening, and currently is fairly even. Actually, Minpoike now getting slightly ahead in that regard, and it's going to be important that he maintains a powerful lead so that when we do get to the upper stages of dampening, and this is one where you may want to start taking your bets because the way that these compositions go head-to-head, we may be breaking records.
I doubt it. I don't think we're getting 85% set, I'm going to be honest. I think the Shadow Priest brings a little bit too much crowd control, and the consistent damage is high. I am curious to see which one of these teams does get an edge. Like you said, the Shaman focusing on a lot of burst, has utility shutdown, whereas the Shadow Priest has good crowd control. In addition to that, it also has a good amount of consistent pressure. Fried Kitty getting bursted down right now. Chaz mana not doing too great. Minpoike actually maybe got a drink in that situation, regenerated some of his mana, and now Change My Mind does have a lead, but with Chaz sitting in stealth and cat form for this long, I can't help but feel like he went for a drink, but I'm unable to find it. He had to come back, assist Raikou. Psychic Horror now secured by Valet. They're looking to get aggressive onto Raikou, potentially forcing out an ice block, but doesn't look like they have the damage to do so just yet.
Currently, we see Chaz very far behind on mana at this point. As Minpoike, is he able to regenerate any off the back of this? We're looking to see. He was able to completely reset his mana. So even though potentially compositionally disadvantaged, Minpoike doing a solid job of making sure that he's got a mana lead over Chaz to try and overcome this disadvantage in game number one. And that's very significant here at 16% dampening. However, pressure has been almost always in favor of Method Black. Valet is constantly at sub 50% health, really no counter pressure against the opposing team Method Black. Swapsy looking to move in and close with that Stormkeeper burst. Valet psychic screaming him away, but still ultimately able to connect. Finally, some damage on Swapsy. Lightning Lasso gets trinketed, so Valet can counter pressure. They sneak in a polymorph. Change My Mind are finding mistakes on the side of Method Black and capitalizing quite effectively to turn this game on its head.
Yeah, Swapsy completely out of mana as well, not able to really heal himself up in this situation. Chaz still caught in crowd control. Nicely done by Minpoike. Swapsy now caught into the Psychic Horror, using Ghost Wolf, trying to kite around the pillar, avoid some of the damage. Raikou looking for some counter pressure now onto Valet. Chaz playing catch up with his Innervate, wants to make all of his casted spells free of mana, and he does manage to top off Swapsy. Good use of Innervate there by Chaz, making sure he can get off that those casted heals.
I think Chaz and Swapsy had a bit of a miscommunication there. You normally don't want to cyclone the Lightning Lasso, so it's the biggest damage output of the team. Chaz then tried to switch it to the Mage Fried Kitty and was able to, but they lost out on a bit of damage there. It's definitely a miscommunication, but you can already see Minpoike, even though he got a massive lead earlier on, is now starting to even out with Chaz. It's still anyone's match here at 24% dampening. Raikou trying to pause out the fight, but Swapsy's got a lot of damage lined up here with two lightning bolts going straight for Valet. Interrupt now on Shadow, denying any sort of defense. That Void Shift, inaccessible in this position. Ray of Frost fully channeled. Lots of damage potentially here to take out Valet. Void Shift still available, but he's trying to hold on to it, instead choosing to line of sight and try and heal himself up with Shadow Mends. Not going to be enough. Huge Earthshock forces Valet to make a trade on that dispersion. He would have liked to have held that cooldown to use for a push later into the fight, and now he will be vulnerable.
Yeah, that's one of the benefits of the Shadow Priest, though. Dispersion and their Fade, that Greater Fade talent, is going to be a really low cooldown. But Delay, very vulnerable right now, only really has the Void Shift. And Poike needs to connect to Ironbark, manages to do so. Valet still looking for damage, but Swafty's been doing a really good job in this matchup, making sure he's wind shearing Valet over and over, really limiting the amount of consistent pressure Valet's been able to put out. Silence now on Chaz has changed my mind, looking to get aggressive, but Swapsy and Raikou, they're just sitting at full health. They really just can't find the damage that they need. And Poike trying to escape for a drink once again, but Chaz chasing him down. Even though Chaz is a little bit below on mana, things are looking good for Method Black.
Yeah, Method Black are very solid in this matchup. The only thing really that's going for Change My Mind is Min Poike's drinks and regeneration and mana management. Currently burst towards Villay as well as Raikou. Both teams continue swinging. Maledict attempt here on Raikou to try and force an ice block. And Poike gets polymorphed. Nice play by Method Black, but Raikou is still low on health, and Chaz doesn't have much mana to recover. He's expending the rest of that mana on a lot of Cyclones. That's going to put him behind, but if they can just net a kill off of it, who really cares? Valet ducking around the corner, avoiding some burst, but still dipping very low. And Poike trades Iron Park, starts to stabilize. Chaz now trying to take the opportunity while the enemy team is pinned down to drink. And Poike does not want to have that happen. That's the only thing they've got going in their favor was a mana lead. And Poike denies the drink. Now they stay in the fight. Valet still getting bursted. They're going to have to babysit Chaz and keep their team alive. If Valet tries to cross into center field to deny a drink, he could just explode. So Minpoike has to be the one to deny drinks and heal his team. So far, he's doing a great job bashing up Chaz now, looking to crowd control. But Raikou backs up Chaz with a blink counter spell. Well timed, and that means that Valet could be in trouble. They silence Swapsy to try and prevent any sort of counter pressure during that scary moment. Good mid-game adaptation by Valet. You would typically only use that silence on a healer, but if you are absolutely desperate, you need to mix up your crowd control usage. Still falling behind, and Poike's having a tough time babysitting Chaz and healing Valet at the same time, and Swapsy and Raikou are trying to capitalize on it.
Yep, that's the added benefit of having most of the pressure go your way. Chaz, once again, can sneak away for a drink, but Poike has to stop him. Chaz can get mana here. It's going to be looking really good for Method Black. That's the only lead Change My Mind has. Chaz is able to regenerate a little bit of mana. Valet still in a little bit of trouble. No dispersion. He does have the Void Shift if he needs it. Vampiric Embrace as well. He gets hexed up. Swapsy and Raikou are going to be looking for some burst out of that if they can. Valet gets wind sheared once again, just over and over. Swapsy just doing a great job with those interrupts. And Poike finds a bash onto Chaz. But just no counter pressure here for the team of Change My Mind. Raikou and Swapsy have been healthy for so long. Now Valet in a Lightning Lasso, trying to heal himself up with the Vampiric Embrace. Trying to sneak away to the pillar. And what was that burst? That was insane.
That's Swapsy.
Throwing at him. So he just needs to adapt his game plan a little bit, I think, in this matchup. Because before dampening, Valet's damage is not going to matter more than Fright Kid is for sure.
Control and damage, two factors that they're going to need to balance here. Method Black, 84% of you think that they're going to be able to take it. 240 points before they even made it to this tournament, and a strong opener on the way.
We see Minpoike playing Feral Affinity at the start of the fight, and that's actually something in the Wizard Cleave mirror that I think the Restoration Druids should consider, because the damage is often so slow outside of very specific windows of burst that during that lull damage point, you can jump in and add extra damage to your team and maybe potentially force a cooldown, or at least force the other team to expend more mana. And I do think Feral Affinity is something that Restoration Druids should be experimenting more with after seeing the success that Garecki has really seen with it. We currently see Minpoike utilizing it quite effectively here on Raikou. He's been tearing into him, even as the healer, just adding a bit of extra damage, pulling Ironbark from Chaz and creating a lot more pressure, at least for his team.
Yeah, and early on in the game, I mean, although Raikou didn't go down, that damage a little bit later on will be significant onto Raikou to potentially take him down. Raikou used his Icy Veins. He's getting polymorphed up, and this is what we wanted to see from Fried Kitty, the freedom to actually get these polymorphs onto Raikou, slow down some of that Frost Mage damage, and potentially that could be favorable for Change My Mind moving forward.
And both druids are running Feral Affinity. Chaz using that Rake Stun into a Cyclone. And Minpoike, I think Minpoike is utilizing it a bit better so far in this match. Chaz seems a little more hesitant to try and get in there and get his paws wet. Actually, no. I swear I saw a Rake Stun, but he's in Boomkin form. I swear I did.
Uh-huh.
I swear I did. I swear I saw Minpoike.
We'll check the VOD.
I swear I saw Minpoike in that.
All right. Well, maybe the stun got reflected, even though it's not possible.
Maybe I'm looking at the wrong druid frame. There's a lot of druids, okay? There's a lot of trees in the forest. They all start looking the same.
Yeah, there's a nice fear coming in from Valet. Good crowd control. Raikou getting a little bit low. Kitty getting bursted down as well. You see it, too?
Yeah, no, I see it. Look at Mipoike, he's in cat form right now.
No, Mipoike has it. I thought I saw Chaz have it when he jumped over, but I'm obviously mixing up the druids here. Mipoike getting bursted, and that is going to be one of the drawbacks of Feral Affinity, is that when you run out in cat form, you're very squishy. You're completely a viable option to attack and take down. So Mipoike needs to juggle both saving his team, healing them up, jumping in, pushing forward, getting aggressive, dealing damage, and then while still avoiding death himself. If he can accomplish all three of these at the same time, then he can definitely carry the team with that affinity. Seems like he wants to jump in over on the side tombstones, but Valet just taking a huge hit as he tried to push forward into Method Black territory.
Yeah, Chaz taking the opportunity there while Raikou was controlling the entire game. He had a polymorph on Valet, interrupt on Fried Kitty. Chaz is able to sneak away and drink to full, resetting his mana, actually giving Method Black the mana lead, and I think that's really good control for Method Black, realizing in the last game they did fall behind on mana, so trying to not fall behind early on is definitely an intelligent play. Cyclone now on Mipoike, Fry Kid again bursting down, he trinkets out of the Lightning Lasso, trying to avoid some of that damage from Swapsy, looking to line of sight as well, needs to stay in LOS or line of sight of Mipoike. Is managing to do so. And I think Mipoike will be able to stabilize here, but still, the mana lead for Method Black is significant.
Yeah, I mean, they've just gotten great crowd control in that entire exchange, and now Fried Kitty's health is paused at low. They're looking to try and rotate crowd control back over to Mipoike and force an ice block potentially, but they're just not able to find it. Mipoike line of sighting. Fried Kitty's still in midfield. I guess with Iron Bark, he's got more than enough defense to stay stable, but now with Lightning Lasso followed by Swapsy, can they get an ice block here? Doesn't look like they have enough damage to do so. Fried Kitty trying to launch an attack back at Raikou, almost a bit randomly, or it's just unfortunate. Valet got polymorphed right when they went for that. You typically see the Gladiator's Maledict coordinated with the team, so one player will launch it first, bait the healer to dispel its healing absorption effect, and then the other two players will follow up with their Gladiator's Maledicts. In that position, Fried Kitty launched his, but his partner, Valet, was crowd-controlled and unable to, so then they become uncoordinated, and it's much less threatening when it's only one to deal. What is happening in this series?
In the last game, I said, you know, Swapsy's Burst, it doesn't happen really off the composition we thought they would bring in game number one. It has been what they've been defaulting to. Besides that Mage Ellie, those two compositions is what we've seen them be the strongest on so far. And I like this adaptation. On the smaller map, it's going to be difficult for Change My Mind to escape from Raikou with those mana rifts already starting off on Mipoike. Good life grip there. Leap of faith by Valet to secure Mipoike away from that mana rift from Raikou, securing his mana for a little bit longer. We're gonna have to look for him to consistently do that whenever it's off cooldown, just to buy Minpoike's mana as much time as possible.
All right, Change My Mind going for Hook Point, a small map, and Method Black say thank you and lock in that Demon Hunter Death Knight composition. And the reason that it is so potent is that as a Restoration Druid, you typically are required to drink to regenerate your mana for a late game play. And on this map, you're not drinking. It's not happening, not on Hook Point. It's too small, it's too narrow. People can get across the map too easily. So Raikou is likely running that Mana Rift ability, the Honor Talent, so he can then burn down the mana of Chaz, build a huge lead there. Sorry, burn down the mana of Mipoike and build a huge lead there. And then due to the map that Changed My Mind have locked in, he's never going to be able to sneak away, drink, and regenerate mana. And Method Black can just take a clean 3-0 here against Change My Mind. Unless they can change my mind with some amount of damage that I've not seen them yet capable of, Method Black are looking strong.
And I just want to say how impressive this is from Method Black. It's very rare. I don't know if we've ever seen it, where two caster players will switch over and play two melee on such a high level, and that is really what makes Method Black such a dangerous team. Raikou is getting low. This is a nice setup from Change My Mind. Iron Bark was committed, but Raikou still with the blur as well as darkness should be able to survive, top himself off now that he's in metamorphosis, that demon form. It's a lot of leech healing, so when you see him in that demon form, whenever he's attacking, he is going to be healing himself up a significant portion of his health. And that's what makes this comp so strong. You have the Death Knight, who has a lot of self-healing, as well as the Demon Hunter, which basically means Chaz doesn't have to use as much mana, and his team is overall just exceptionally durable.
You'll often see Mipoike just use his Gladiator's Medallion to remove stuns from Raikou, and this is so that he can dodge the Mana Rift. Earlier on in the last stun, Valet used Life Grip to be able to pull Minpoike away from the stun mana rift combination and avoid its mana draining effect. If they can coordinate these two spells together, they can drag on the fight to potentially open up opportunities to kill a target later into dampening. And dampening is pretty much required when facing this Demon Hunter, Death Knight, Restoration Druid combination. Restoration Druid is the king of the healers, definitely on top. Its only weakness right now is that it does need to drink frequently, which you can capitalize with small maps, but in general, it is the best healer overall. Demon Hunters bring in consistently insanely high self-healing mechanics, as already explained through Leech. As you can see, Raikou uses I-Beam. It activates this metamorphosis ability where he grows wings, he becomes gigantic, and every attack he does heals him for a significant amount. Then, of course, we have Death Knight here for Swapsy. He brings in Death Strike, which heals him for a significant amount of his own health. So you pair this individual self-healing capabilities along with the most powerful healer in the game, and you've got a recipe that's going to take it into really deep dampening. So Change My Mind have to survive and maintain their mana until that point so they can reduce the effectiveness of this leech healing from Raikou and Deathstrike of Swapsy. There may be potential in dampening, but then even at that point, there are very powerful team defensive cooldowns for the composition that Method Black have as well, that being Darkness from Raikou. So at any point, Raikou can place a purple cloud on the ground, which will have a chance to immune basically all incoming damage. There's about a 30% chance that something will hit him, but it's very unlikely. Although those Earthshocks earlier in the game, maybe there is a chance that it could happen. This is also one of the powerful team defensive cooldowns currently activated with that purple shield that is Swapsy's anti-magic zone. So during those critical burst moments, they will almost always have an available cooldown trade to negate a kill from the composition that Change My Mind have brought here, which is why they are so heavily favored compositionally, so heavily favored on the map. Change My Mind need a miracle.
Yeah, and Swapsy really playing to that advantage. He's actually playing the PvP talent Transfusion, so every 45 seconds he can reduce the cost of his Death Strike by 50% for 7 seconds. So that gives him a lot of self-healing every 45 seconds that he can use to top himself off. He's going to be dropping that Raise Abomination we often see Death Knights play, but he realizes his win condition is just to survive as long as possible, limit the amount of damage that Fried Kitty and Valet can really do, not die, and eventually Minpoike will go due to the mana rifts of Raikou. On this map, it's just so hard to avoid, and Method Black, similar to how we saw Method Orange, is implementing this strategy quite beautifully. I mean, it's difficult for Change My Mind. They're a very high caliber team, especially on this Shadow Priest Mage comp, but Fried Kitty with Swapsy just sitting on him the whole game, his damage is so limited. He's just getting interrupted, Mind Freeze, he gets interrupted by the Ghoul over and over and over, and he's not able to consistently drop out the Blizzard and get the Frostbolts he needs to do significant damage.
I will say Minpoike and Valet have been doing a good job of dodging as many mana rifts as physically possible, so they at least have some opportunity here as dampening has just begun. But as you can already see, Minpoike tried to sneak away and get a drink. This map is too small for him to do so. I do not like that they picked Hook Point. If they were really having to rely on this composition, it was just not a wise move, at least if they wanted to have more games on the board potentially to throw the series back. Maybe they're just saying, well, if we can't win on this map, we can't win anyway because we're gonna have to play on two small maps even if we win this next game. But I'm not sold on that 100%. Icy Veins currently activated, so this is typically where you will see a trade from Raikou with Darkness, as it lines up so efficiently with Icy Veins and potentially needed. Raikou gets mind controlled at low health. Iron Bark before dampening is likely to be enough damage reduction for Raikou to safely stabilize throughout this pressure. Now getting back on target, I-Beam. So now all of his attacks start healing him. You can see his health going up quite rapidly as a result. Valet getting pressured down. Valet also brings in a little bit of self-healing, but I wouldn't say it's as potent, at least not against single target pressure as Raikou's or Swapsy's is. There's another Mana Rift timed there with the Nursel's Vortex. I'm not sure if it was actually entirely able to connect onto Minpoike as he's jumping in to get crowd control for the team. Finally, Change My Mind are starting to initiate some crowd control and trying to find some burst opportunities. Just before we get to something like 30% dampening is when you want to be getting Raikou's Darkness, so that when we're at 40 or 50 or 60% dampening, he doesn't have it, and then you can actually find a kill. But if Raikou can hold on to Darkness until that 50, 60% dampening, he can use that to immune a kill and then run down the enemy team. We already see pressure establishing itself across all three members of Change My Mind.
Yeah, and this is looking like a tag team tournament. Anytime Raikou's getting targeted down, caught in Novas, and has to play a little bit defensive, you immediately see Swapsy run over to Minpoike and say, well, if Raikou can't sit on you, I certainly will. That will keep Minpoike's mana at a critical level. Poike on 50% right now, still has his Innervate active, so he might be able to top off Fried Kitty. In terms of defensive cooldowns, Change My Mind is still doing quite well, but often what we see from a composition like Method Black, when you go up against them, things are stable, you have all your defensives, and then your healer goes out of mana, and then things just start spiraling out of control. You'll see Dispersion, Void Shift, both Ice Blocks pulled out rapidly, especially as we move towards the 30-40% dampening. The Method Black can keep up the pressure and just stop Poike from drinking at basically all costs.
Pressure on Fried Kitty here by Method Black as dampening ramps up. Damage becomes more valuable than healing. I mean, Poike actually did manage to sneak away. How much mana did he ultimately get?
It's
better than nothing, especially on this map. He's actually got a lead over Chaz, and Poike has been doing everything he can for his team, but the compositions that they've brought in the current meta are just not enough to take down the compositions that these types of calibers of teams have brought in, such as Method Black, and as we saw earlier in the tournament. So I'm not sure if they've got what it takes to go all the way, but they're trying to do everything in their power to make it happen. Can they do it battling against the meta? Another important thing to take note is that these players are playing on a tournament server, which means they have access to the highest item level gear in the game, basically the best gear in the game. And when you have high item level Azerite gear, you actually have 20%, I believe, more maximum health than in any other patch of this expansion. So these teams just have huge health pools, which then makes percentage-based damage even more valuable. Currently a big attack here on Raikou. This is where they would have liked to be getting the darkness, but at least they get the anti-magic zone at that 20 to 30% mark. If they can keep pressure up and get darkness here as well, it's definitely going to be critical if Change My Mind are going to be able to take this game. They're not finding enough damage to do so. Valet now on the back foot, and Poike trying to stabilize. Change My Mind doing a phenomenal job, but I just don't know if they're going to be able to overcome this disadvantage.
No, we'll definitely have to see. So far, they have been making it work. There's been signs of life on Raikou. Chaz with no Trinket, no Iron Bark. Raikou as well, no Blur, so that's his main defensive cooldown he has available. Filet and Fry Kitty can get another nice setup here with crowd control on Chaz. Raikou could certainly have to pull up the potential darkness in this next exchange, but Raikou's going to be moving over onto Poike once again. You can see his mana is just taxed so much. Chaz sitting in cat form, trying to potentially get out of combat, forcing Fry Kitty and Filet to be distracted in the matchup. But I really am impressed with how Change My Mind is playing this. Poike's been able to hold on to that mana for so long.
Yeah, his coordination with Valet has been critical here on Hook Point. And if they can take the worst map for them out of the pool, maybe they do stand a chance to come back in the series, but they need to get that darkness from Raikou. And if they can't get it within the next 10% of dampening, I think they are going to be overwhelmed with pressure. So, and that number gets to 40%. They need to have gotten through it. Can they do it? They do have a significant mana lead, actually, which is quite surprising. And I mean, Chaz has the same disadvantage on Hook Point. He actually can't really drink either. Valet gets crowd control onto Chaz. Raikou reverse magics it, but now potential opening for Polymorph. If Fried Kitty can sneak in one, he gets it. Good opportunity for Change My Mind to try and force a darkness. They need damage. It's just not there. Raikou is just so easily deflecting it with Blur activated. Basically, Chaz and Raikou can make trades with Iron Bark and Blur as they are basically the same cooldown, and you just rotate them one after the other. And then if one of those isn't available, you then look to use a team cooldown, so something like Darkness or Anti-Magic Zone. And because Method Black's defensive rotation has been on point, no real big overlaps there, and the potency of their self-healing, Change My Mind just aren't finding that opening that they need. They got maybe another 5% of dampening to get darkness from Raikou, but they're getting overwhelmed already with Fried Kitty down at around 20%. And Poike's mana still looks somewhat serviceable here in game number three. As they're on match point, they have to win this or they're out of the tournament.
Yet Change My Mind getting lower, all three members. How's been Poike gonna deal with it? But big burst on Raikou. Anti-magic zone does get dropped out. Can Raikou survive? Chaz doesn't have much mana left to work with. Might have to drop out the darkness, but Raikou manages to stabilize. Fried Kitty still low, as well as Valet. Now I'm in Poike in a bash. First ice block gets forced out, and this is the moment I'm talking about in the game. At 30-40% dampening, this is when we're going to start seeing every single defensive cooldown from Change My Mind forced out if Method Black can continue the pressure.
Yeah, and at this point, they're really not looking too good. Raikou has his Blur rotated back up, Iron Bark for Chaz, and Darkness. So three options that Change My Mind have to try and push through. Maybe with one big push, they can get all three, but if they can't do it like that, I'm not sure. Icy Veins popped. Raikou just trades Blur. efficient trade there on his part to stay aggressive and try and just close this game out, as both druids are completely tapped on mana. But of course, the damage of Method Black is going to be more significant because the Demon Hunter and Death Knight heal themselves, whereas the Mage doesn't heal himself. And the Shadow Priest does, but not nearly as effective. Raikou imprisoning up Fried Kitty so that Swapsy can make his way and reconnect, potentially, and Death Gripping Valet over. That seemed like a miscommunication. I think Swapsy wanted to set up Raikou for a double stun, but then they ended up splitting out with Raikou going after Minpoike. Mana Rift secures the remainder of Minpoike's mana. And at this point, what can you really do is change your mind? Maybe you can go after the Death Knight, try and crowd control Raikou to deny his darkness onto him. There is some option there, but the momentum is just swinging out of control here. Right, Fried Kitty gets interrupted. Ooh, Void Shift is traded by Valet to stay alive as he could not access Ice Block while interrupted, but now Valet is low on health. He has to trade Dispersion. Minpoike is getting overwhelmed. There's no counter aggression. It's been a completely one-sided match, and Change My Mind, I think, are out of opportunities.
Yeah, this is difficult. Method Black, they're here to win, going to be looking to march through the lower bracket and get into that grand finals to secure their third cup in a row. Change My Mind, holding on by a thread, trying to stay in it, but it's just looking so grim. Minpoike with the innervate, trying to get some heals out. Valet still low. Fried Kitty as well. He has a nice block left, but he gets interrupted. And now at this point, Raikou's sitting on Fried Kitty. Swapsy sitting on Valet. Minpoike, this is a nightmare situation. Chaz secures a full Cyclone into a Bash on the Trinket. But still, Change My Mind, they are holding on. I just don't see how they can recover, Sid.
Ice block forced again. Burst on Raikou. They have to kill him in this Bash. They don't have enough damage to do it. Anti-magic zone, once again from Swapsy, protects Raikou, but it limits his mobility. He actually can't move from it without losing its damage reduction, so at least they can slow down some damage. I don't think it matters. There's no defense left. Method Black, play it out clinically, precisely. No mistakes made here. Minpoike is doing everything in his power to try and keep his team alive in this tournament. Valet's Vampiric Embrace, this is a cooldown that allows his damage to heal the team. Maybe that's enough to keep them at least alive, but there's still just no counter pressure whatsoever. They can't find any openings, and Swapsy is looking to close. He gets two big zaps in game one and two, switches over to the Death Knight, and basically strangles Change My Mind to death here on match point. Method Black advanced 3-0.
And the feed versus the fake zebras, we're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.